Hey y'all, in this video I'm going to get into the use offsets option within job setup. So we'll go up here to create new file, and what I'm talking about is this option right down here within the XY datum position. I have a project that I need to use this on, and I thought that this would be a great opportunity to demonstrate this option. So let's go outside and I'll show you what I have going on. Okay, so here's the situation. Normally, what I like to do is use my work offsets that I have programmed into Mach 4. So I'll start Mach 4, go into my offsets, select my G55 offset, and that puts my XY0 right here on this corner. And that works for most every project I have done since I set up that work offset. Well, here's the situation on this particular piece. I need to surface this piece down. It's too big to go through my planer. The way I set up my surfacing toolpaths is my bit moves 2.5 inches beyond the front and back of the piece that I'm surfacing, so that all of my X movements take place out here, not on the material. The problem is, my machine won't physically go 2.5 inches past the front of the table. So what I need to do is I need to space this back away from the front edge of the table. Now, yes, I could set my XY0 to the center and just manually do this. But this is a great opportunity to use the offsets within the VCarve software. What I will do is I'll take a couple of scrap pieces of wood and stick them up here on these offset pegs, then fasten my material down here using these as a spacer to space my material 3 inches away in Y and in X from the front of this machine and from the side of the machine. That gives me a known location where I can use my G55 work offset, and with the offset selected in Vectric, I will machine this piece out here, not worry about it coming off the front, and I don't have to modify G-code. Let's get into the software and I'll show you what I mean. Now back here in the software, I can continue creating this file. Now, it's a single-sided job. I already have the dimensions of my material entered. I'm going to Z0 set to the material surface. And my XY datum position, I want the position to be the bottom left corner. And I am going to use an offset, so I'll put a check mark here. And I'm going to make these positive offsets. So in X, I'll go 3.0. And look at what is going on with the diagram out here. My material is moved over from my X0 line, and it'll move up from the Y0 line as soon as I enter 3.0. And now my material is here, but my XY0 is down here. I'm going to click OK. And now what I have told the software is, when I set my XY0 outside on the machine, that XY0 is going to be right here. This is the location of my G55 work offset. What I've just done is I've told the software that my material is actually over here. 3 inches up in Y and 3 inches over in X. Where did I get that 3 inches? That is the width of those two pieces of scrap material I showed you outside. So now I can continue creating my design. I'm going to surface that piece of material. I want it to be a half inch wider on each side than my material is. This rectangle is going to be a total of 1 inch wider than my X dimension. So I'll go X plus 1 equals. Then I want the rectangle to be longer than my material by a total of 5 inches, because I want that bit to come off of the material this way 2.5 inches, and I want it to go off of the material this way 2.5 inches. So I'll go Y plus 5 equals. I'll create that rectangle. Then I'll center my rectangle. Now I'm ready to calculate the tool path. I'm going to use a simple pocket tool path to remove 20/1000ths of an inch off of the surface per pass. But if we look down here, when that bit comes down to pocket out this material, it's going to stay a half inch away from that Y0 line on my machine. From here, I'll go ahead and create my tool path, save G code, then go out on the CNC router and start carving. Outside on the CNC router, I could then mount my material using those 3 inch wide pieces of scrap as spacers to space them away from the steel dowels that I use to register from my G55 work offset. Once I was sure the material was fastened down completely, I could go ahead and remove those pieces of scrap wood. Then remove the steel dowels that I used as registration pins. I could then load the G-code, mount the tool in my spindle, set my Z0, and surface my project. I was able to surface this piece of material and not worry about the machine crashing when it moved up towards the front to machine that area. Then it was a simple matter to flip the material over and repeat the process on the other side. If you didn't see the video where I demonstrated how to create that G55 work offset, I'll go ahead and put a link to it in a card in the upper right corner of the screen right about now, and I've put a link to it down in the description box as well. This side was a little bit more uneven than the first side, so I had to make a couple of extra passes, but in the end, I was able to get it surfaced nice and smooth, then carry on with the project. So that's it. That's all there really is to using the use offset option within job setup in the Vectric software. Now, as I mentioned in the video, I could have very easily mounted that material out here somewhere and marked the center of my XY0 and machined it from there. But again, I thought this was a great opportunity to show one use of the use offsets option within job setup. And this can come in handy in various situations. For instance, if you have a fixture that you mount to your table to hold a piece of work material, you can mount that fixture, mount your material in that fixture, set your XY0 to a known position on that fixture, then tell the software that the material is actually somewhere else up here. There are several situations where this option can come in very handy. So, at least now you know a little bit about it and can go from there. Now, I know there's no way I answered every question you may have about using this option in the software. So this afternoon at noon Pacific, 3 p.m. Eastern, I'll be hosting a live Q&A session where you can ask me any question you'd like about anything I've presented in this video or any of my other videos. That's this afternoon at noon Pacific, 3 p.m. Eastern, right here on my YouTube channel. And I put a link to that live Q&A session down in the description box of this video. Now, before we wrap this up, I'd like to give a special shout out and say a special thank you to my channel members. Thank you, channel members, for your continued support. I appreciate it. If you would like information on how to become a channel member, just click that little join button down below this video panel somewhere. Another panel will pop up and a video will play that'll tell you all about channel membership. We have a great crew and we'd love to have you join us. So, I hope to see you all this afternoon for the live Q&A session. And as always, whether you subscribe to my channel or not, whether you become a channel member or not, I'd like to thank you very much for taking the time to watch. Y'all take care.